So, Mum's the Word with Cilla's special surprise surprise.
Mother's Day edition of Surprise Surprise. And look, just look what I got this morning on this very special Mother's Day. These flowers were waiting for me on my kitchen table, ladies and gentlemen. Look at that, aren't they gorgeous? I've got roses here, carnations, chrysanthemums. You know, I'm growing all these flowers in the greenhouse, you know I am. Hang on. You're not thinking what I'm thinking, are you, girls? My lads wouldn't take my flowers from the greenhouse, would they?
Yes!
Yes, they would, they would. But how many mums received a bunch of flowers today? Give us a wave. Oh, yes. Quite a lot of you. Quite a lot of you, but not all the mums' hands went up, did they? Ah, big flowers on Mother's Day, don't we?
Yeah!
And surprise, surprise, you are all going to get flowers. Yes. Where are my big fellas? Are you a mum?
Yes.
You are. Oh, well, congratulations. You've got a very sorry-looking daffodil there. At least you've got it. What's your name?
Debbie.
Debbie. How many children have you got?
One and one on the way.
Oh! Well, Debbie, try not to have it before the end of the show, all right, children? Are there any mums over here?
Yeah.
Oh, yeah. What's your name, sweetheart?
Chris.
Chris. You're a mum?
I am.
How many children have you got?
Four.
Four? You look well on it, don't you? How old are they? What are they?
Three boys and a girl.
Oh, three boys and a girl.
22 down to 11.
22? Who's the 22-year-old one?
My eldest son.
Oh, what's his name?
Jason.
What does our Jason do?
He's in the Navy.
Oh, in the Navy. Where's he stationed at the minute?
He's in the Gulf at the moment.
I bet you didn't get flowers today because of his work.
No.
Oh, never. Big up. Oh, never mind. Any more mums? What about you, Chuck? Are you a mum?
Yes.
What's your name?
Heather.
Hi, Heather. Have you got any children?
Yes.
Yes, how many?
Three.
All in the Navy.
All in the... Oh, do you know Christine at the back?
No, we got one in the Gulf.
Three. Do you know, snap, I've got three. Our Robert, our Ben and our Jack.
Yeah.
What are yours called?
Christian, Daniel and Matthew.
Really? Where are they all serving then?
One's in Vietnam, one's in St. Lucia, and one's in Portsmouth.
Did Daniel send you any flowers?
No.
How old is Daniel?
24.
Oh, 24. Well, he's a bit young, you see, and, you know, all that way over there. Where'd you say he was again?
St. Lucia.
Oh, you see, sunning himself on the beach. You're Daniel. Well, you are both going to get flowers now because I think you're lovely mums, all right? And here's a special delivery. And guess who's going to deliver them? Your son Daniel, all the way from the Caribbean. And yes, your Jason, all the way from the Gulf. empty-handed, aren't you, girls? Yeah. All right, well, for the second time tonight, let them have it, fellas! Are you all right, Chuck?
Yes.
Because, I mean, you did a little jump there.
I did.
You did when you heard the noise. What's your name?
May.
May. Well, May, relax. Let your nerves settle. I might chat to you later on. All right. Well done, May. Well done, May. Now. Well, now we've got a bit of an interruption coming up, but as far as I'm concerned, this fella can interrupt me anytime. He's got a special message for a special mum in our audience tonight. So, ladies and gentlemen, please welcome the one and only Neil Diamond.
Hi, Cilla. I'm sorry I can't be there right now, but I'm about to go on stage here at Wembley. But I do know you have a special fan in the audience, Bernadette Abbott. Can you find her for me?
I certainly will, Neil. Bernadette Abbott, where are you? Neil wants you. Oh, she's over there. Bernadette, stand up. Let's have a look at you. Give a wave. Give a wave, Bernadette. Not at me. No, at Neil. There she is. I found a Neil for you.
Hi, Bernadette. I know you want to come see the show, and as a matter of fact, Cilla's got two tickets for you right now.
I have got the tickets, I have got the... And I wish I was going to be there with you, Neil, as well, because I love you to death. But I can't, because I've got to do a show like Surprise, Surprise.
And I think Cilla's got a copy of my new movie album for you. Thank you, Cilla, for that fast car you've got waiting outside. Let's just put Bernadette in it and bring her right over here. Bernadette, come backstage and give me a big hug and a kiss, because the audience is waiting. But I'll wait here for you, okay? Thank you, Cilla. Thank you, everybody.
Oh, not me. I've waited 30 years for this.
Have you been? Well, you don't look old enough. You don't look old enough, Ben.
I am.
30 years you've waited. And now you're going to see Neil. Not only that, you're going in a fast car, because that's waiting. Wembley's waiting. Neil's waiting. You heard him. He's waiting for a kiss backstage. I can't believe it. It's not fair. He did say I've got the tickets. There's your tickets,
no,
Chuck.
Thank you.
And there's the album that needs to be signed. All right, sweetheart. Mm-hmm. And it's your Debbie. Your Debbie's got to take her, because she'll never get there on her own. Not in this state. Give my love to Neil, all right? Enjoy the... I'm so sorry you're leaving. I bet you're mortified that you
can't...
No. Well, there's two. Enjoy the show, ladies and gentlemen. Happy birthday. It all, doesn't it? And don't you wish you were going with them?
Yes.
Well, hard luck. Someone's got to stay with me, and here, just to make you all a little bit jealous, is a taste of what we're all missing.
And when two lovers woo, they still say I love you. On that you can rely. No matter what the future brings, as time goes by.
Well, I want to have a word with someone in our audience now, and surprise, surprise, it is you, Jessica Todd. Yes, little Jessica, come down and join me on the Cilla sofa. I want to have a talk to you. Now, Jessica, you're down here because your lovely mum up there, Sandra, give us a wave, Sandra. She wrote and told me about you and all what you did for actually a friend of your brother's, Matthew, because Matthew was involved in a terrible road accident, wasn't he?
Yeah.
And he was more than badly hurt. It left him paralysed, didn't it? Well, you were a great friend. You went to visit him many times in hospital. And talking, making him feel happy and everything. Not only that, he needed a wheelchair, didn't he, obviously, because of the terrible injuries. And you took it upon yourself to raise some money. Now, what did you actually do to raise money for Matthew's wheelchair?
I did a 5-mile sponsored swim for him at my local sports centre.
5 miles? Well, well done, Jessica. Does he have his wheelchair yet?
Yeah, he has his wheelchair.
And that's all thanks to you.
He comes round it near every day now, and so.
Ah, well, well done, Jessica. We need more kids like this. We do. We should promote children like this. And now your mum also tells me that you obviously all 12-year-olds, they love to sing and dance, and you love all the boy bands, don't you? And one of your favourite bands, I mean, all five of them you love. Who would they be?
Five.
It would be five. Well, you know, I got on the phone to the band. I did. And I told them what you'd done for Matthew. And they now think that you are their favourite fan. And they wanted to thank you in person. And that's exactly what they've done. And surprise, surprise, here they all are. Five. Come in now. Sir, sweetheart.
Cheers, my son.
Is this a nice surprise or what? Well, you did. You thought she was brilliant, didn't you, raising all these?
Absolutely. Yes, but it was very
if we had brilliant. Hats, we'd take them off.
You didn't hesitate when we asked you to come on the show.
No.
And you brought a few goodies along.
We have brought some goodies. There's
for our
two albums. There's some tops and a signed thing from all of us.
Yes.
Round of applause.
Gonna sing a song for us.
Third single, which is called Got the Feeling. Especially
the feeling.
For you.
Have you got the feeling,
yes,
Jessica?
I have.
Would you like to take our Jessica off?
Come on, Jessica.
And I shall give you a nice introduction. Ladies and
gentlemen,
Jessica and for number one fan Jessica, it's Five singing Got the Feeling.
Here we go again with the beats. We got your heads bumping, now you're jumping from your seats. If this is what you're wanting over there, throw your hands up in the air, because you know we bring the sound so unique. Now everybody's moving, everybody's grooving, getting down with Five when we come your way. Move it to the left, now you shake it to the right, because you know we gotta keep this party bumping through the night. Check me out.
Hey, yo, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. I'm on the microphone, got you hot like the sun. So I 1, 2, 3, now I'm waiting on the floor. Kick down the door and turn it up a little more.
You got the feeling, jump up to the ceiling, I'll be getting down tonight. One if you're gonna, two if you wanna.
Cause we're gonna take you through into the dawn. Everybody's moving, everybody's grooving. Getting down with Five when we come your way. So raise up your arms as we drop it on the one. You see we're gonna carry on because the fun has just begun. Check us out.
Hey yo, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. I'm on the microphone, got you hot like the sun. So I 1, 2, 3, now I'm waiting on the floor. Kick down the door and turn it up a little more.
You got the feeling, jump up to the ceiling. I'll get it down tonight. One if you're gonna, two if you want.
In the past on Surprise Surprise, but this one really takes some beating. I am now going to surprise Danny Flitcroft, but that's not his original name because he's from Vietnam and his Vietnamese name is Nang. Now, Danny is blind following an accident during the war in Vietnam when he was just 6 years old. Well, he thinks he's here to do a radio interview. I wonder what he'll say when I surprise him on the telephone.
Hello.
Hello. Hello, is that Jeanette?
It is.
Jeanette, can I speak to Danny, please?
You can, just a moment. Danny.
Here. Hello.
Hi, Danny.
Hi.
Hi, Danny. Surprise, surprise. It's Cilla here.
Hello?
Hello, it's Cilla here, Danny.
Yeah?
Are you there? Is that your wife, Jeanette, there with you, Danny?
Yes.
Now, sweetheart, I know you think you've come to do a radio interview, is that right?
Yeah.
Well, the truth is, you've come to do an interview with me on the telly.
Oh.
So will you come and join me on the famous Cilla sofa, please, Danny?
Sure.
Oh, thanks a lot. See you in a mo.
Okay.
Wonderful, there you are. Are you comfortable?
Yes, thank you.
Danny, welcome to the Surprise Surprise studio. You know, yours is an incredible story. I hardly know where to start, sweetheart. Yeah. I know that you're now happily married to Jeanette and you're living in Redditch, near Birmingham. Is that right?
Yes.
But you were born in Vietnam.
That's right.
And I want you to take you all that way back during the war in Vietnam when you were just 6 years of age. And a terrible war accident happened to you.
Yeah. Well, first of all, my village was captured by the communist army from the north. And then a few months, I think, then the American combined with the Vietnamese forces tried to recapture the village. So the American warplane came and bombarded the village, and my family and I and our friends fled into the jungle. And we went to live in the cave in the jungle.
How long after this did you get injured with the grenade?
When my brother and mother went to find food in the village, when they returned back to the cave, and my brother found a booby trap, a hand grenade, and he brought it home to the cave. And I didn't know what it was, so when I saw the bomb, I took it and pulled off the pin, and it exploded in my hand. And see this, the scar there. This chemical, you know, hit my eyes, you know, so it damaged the optic nerve.
Yes, I know.
And then I became blind then. And so one night, my mom packed my bag and sent me to to escape with the groups. But Nin, my brother, was not with me at that time. Anyway, I went ahead with the group. A few days later, Mom decided to send Nin to find me so that he could look after me, you know, because I was blind, you see. And then we heard the news from our friends who were escaping. A few days later, they told us that my mother was killed by the bomb.
But, I mean, the good news was that you were fostered by an English couple, is that right?
Yeah, that's right, by Barry and Tilly Flitcroft.
Well, your foster parents actually brought you over to Britain, is that right?
Yes, that's right.
And you thrived over here. And then how long ago was it? I mean, when did you get... You got the most surprising letter out of the blue, giving you some fabulous information. What was that letter about?
My foster family took me to live with them in Korea. And while I was there, I attended a Saturday school, you know, because there was no blind school over there. So in the school, there was a Vietnamese librarian. When he spotted me, he knew that I was a Vietnamese, you know. So he came to talk to me, and then I told him about my life story. And he said to me he would help to write a letter to my village to see if my brother is still alive. And so he wrote the letter to the village, and somebody got the letter and gave it to my brother, and he wrote back, and he told me that he found my mother and my sister were alive and well. But one thing which made me sad, because according to that letter, my mom begged me to go back to Vietnam so that she could look at me one more time before she dies.
Well, can I tell you something now, Danny?
Yeah.
We sent a team of researchers all the way over to Vietnam to try and find your family, because I have to say, ladies and gentlemen, Danny's family live in a very tiny, remote village way, way up there in the mountains in North Vietnam. Is that right?
Yes.
And it's very difficult to find, but our researchers found your family. And guess what? Your brother is there, and your mother, and your sister, and they all live next door to each other. Mm. Now, I know your mum to this day and your sister have never, ever left that village at all.
Yeah.
And they've never even been to a big city, let alone been on a plane, until tonight. Because, Danny, surprise, surprise, after over 30 years, we've flown them over here to be with you on Mother's Day. Here they are, your mum, Nan, your brother, Nin, and your sister, Lam. Here they are, to my left. Couple of minutes. See you then.
That's £1.30.
If you were short-changed by as little as 50p, you wouldn't stand for it, would you?
Excuse me?
But thousands of you have been short-changed by as much as £4,000 or more and have yet to receive a penny back. If you were sold a personal pension between April 88 and June 94, you could receive this letter, which we've asked your pension company to send you. It will tell you what to do.
Hey, excuse me!
Sorry?
I think you made a mistake.
And if you're one of those owed money...
Sorry.
You'll get it back. Miss sold a pension, they owe you.
And there's more drama coming soon from On Digital. There's Peak Practice.
Hey!
There's also ER.
Someone's down!
And all through your aerial from On Digital. Great drama, all for less per day than the cost of a newspaper. And of course, there's the X-Files.
I just wish I knew what the hell was going on.
They got the original Defense Department's UFO intelligence files.
Something to tell your friends about. Not that they believe you. They think you just imagined it.
On Digital. More choice through your aerial. Call 0808 100 0101 or pop down to your local high street.
Oh, no. Oh.
What's up, love?
This project. I'm in real trouble if I don't finish it.
What's it about, son?
The ancient Egyptians.
Well, it's all Greek to me. Mind you, pyramids did inspire the new PG Tips bag.
Eh?
Just look at it. The eighth wonder of the world. Roomier, tastier and filled with treasure.
Looks like you could do with a cup.
With PG's new pyramid bags, tips never tasted so good. Because they give more room to move than our flat bag ever could.
How's your tea, love?
10 out of 10. But, Dad, how did they build the pyramids?
Don't know, son. Ask your mummy.
Oh.
Travelling with any baggage?
Yeah, here he comes now.
Looking at?
Hey, no peanut jokes.
I feel so violated. What is so suspicious about candy-coated chocolates who walk and talk? I guess you gotta check out everybody, though.
Wow.
Great casting job. Excuse me, gorgeous. Is this a snack flight?
It is now.
Lots of lovely, cheerful faces over here, and I've got a surprise for just one of them, and I think it's you.
But yes, it is you. What's your name?
Sue.
It's Sue. Oh, it's not you, Sue. No, I'm sorry about that. It's you, Lillian. I'm sorry, Sue. It's you, Lillian. I've got a surprise for. Oh, shove up, Chuck. Let's get inside. Oh, how embarrassing. I went to Sue down there and I was looking for a short-haired person and it was you, Lillian.
Lovely, very nice.
Is this your Jackie over
That's
here?
That's Jackie, yeah.
Well, Jackie, you're to blame for all this, aren't you? Because you wrote and told me about your lovely mum, Lillian. Now, Lillian, Jackie tells me that you're absolutely mad about trains. And you've got this burning desire to travel in the lap of luxury on one of them. Is that right?
On the Orient Express.
Oh, right away, the Orient Express. You don't get any blusher than that. Well, surprise, surprise, you are going on the Orient Express. Yes, to travel in the lap of luxury. Oh, yes.
I can't believe it.
Oh, better believe it, Lillian. Yes, you're going to have the most fabulous away day. You're drinking the champagne, all the fabulous food, and here to deliver your special ticket is your very own steward from the Orient Express.
Oh, no.
His name's Lenny. He's going to look after you. Come in, Lenny. There's your champagne. Oh, hey.
Thank you,
Ron.
Oliver
Cheers. And there's your tickets. Look at that.
Do you enjoy it?
Oh, lovely. Thanks ever so much.
I must say you're dressed for it, Lenny. He can't wait to take you off. Take her off, Lenny, and enjoy your day on the Orient Express. Sorry about before. I'm sorry I didn't have a surprise for you then.
It doesn't matter.
Well, it does actually, because I've got a surprise for you now. Come on. Come with me, Sue, on the Cilla sofa. I bet you're wondering who wrote and tell me all about you, Sue.
I think I've got a good idea.
Yes, it's your Debbie up there. She's the culprit. She told me that you're a gorgeous mum and she loves you dearly and she wanted something a bit special for you on Mother's Day. Now, how many children do you have?
Two.
You've got two. And you've got a lot of pets, Debbie says.
Yes.
How many pets have you got?
Nine altogether.
Now, oh, what are they? Nine. What are
they? There's five guinea pigs.
Oh.
There's a rat.
A rat?
Yes.
A rat. What else? That's six.
A cat.
A cat, seven.
And two dogs.
And two dogs. What are their names?
Zara and Mister.
Oh, really? Well, I happen to know that you've got three dogs, actually.
Well, I have, yeah. I've got a sponsored dog as well.
You have got a sponsored dog, haven't you?
Yeah.
Now, what's your sponsored dog's name?
Christopher.
Christopher. What make is he?
He's a lurcher.
He's a lurcher. Oh, isn't that lovely? Now, have you ever met Christopher? Have you ever seen him?
Oh. I've got a photograph.
Oh, so you've seen him, but you've not met him?
No.
Now, where does Christopher live, then? You've been sponsoring him.
I think it's in Dumfries.
He's up there in Scotland, but I know he's up there in Scotland. Now, we've told Christopher to watch the telly. Yes, because we told him that you're going to send him a little message. So where's your camera? It's way, way over there. In doggy speak, say hello to Christopher. What have you got
hello, Christopher. Woof, woof.
Well, I wonder if he'll say woof, woof back. Shall we find out?
Shall we give it a go?
No, well, he's not in Dumfries in Scotland. Surprise, surprise. You're going to meet him for the very first time. Your doggy. Here he is. Christopher. Come in, Christopher, with Lisa. Here's your mummy, Christopher. Oh, look. You thought you'd never see your mummy at all. He's gorgeous, Christopher. Yes, well, we've got some lovely champagne and doggy biscuits. By the way, the champagne's for you, the doggy biscuits are for you. Well, enjoy your new son, Christopher, all right. One woman and her dog. Ladies and gentlemen, Sue Chester and Christopher, not forgetting Lisa. Off you go. Doggy biscuits are waiting. And your champagne. Well, now then, a little quiz for all of you. What of the Spice Girls, the Corrs, Robson and Jerome, and 911 all got in common? Now, does anybody know?
No!
I heard that. I heard someone said they've got loads of money. Who said that?
Yes.
A little hand going up there. I shall tell you, the thing those fabulous acts have in common is they made their TV debut on the same show. And guess what show they made their debut on?
Surprise!
Who said that was rehearsed? Yes, it was us. And I think that proves that we can pick them. And of course, the question everybody's asking is, who's next? Well, if you want to know the answer, watch this.
Maria, surprise, surprise!
Please do.
Because I want to meet your mate. Can I do that?
Coming through.
Thanks a lot. Step inside, love. You lead the way. You lead the way.
Anne.
Hello, Anne. Surprise, surprise.
Oh, my God!
Now, you're Maria, you're Anne.
Yes.
And you're Ragnachinda.
That's right.
Now, you're three mums with a difference. You're very special mums. Because you've got four very beautiful daughters between you, haven't you? Now, your daughters are daughters with a difference. Why? They've all got something in common. What's that?
The band.
They are a girl band, aren't they?
There they are.
Hi, gorgeous girls. Introduce yourselves. What's your names? Oh, I love the eyes. What's your name?
I'm Leanne.
Leanne.
I'm Fiona.
Fiona.
I'm Mim.
Mim.
I'm Kate.
And Kate. Now, you met at school, obviously. Yeah, you got together.
Yeah.
And you formed a band, is that right?
Yeah.
Yep. And what do you call yourselves?
The 21st Century Girls.
And I know mums, it's always been your dearest wish to see your girls perform live on television.
It is.
Correct.
Oh, isn't that nice? Well, surprise, surprise, they're going to do that now. Hello, everyone.
Hello.
Surprise, surprise. I'm here for a very, very special reason. I'm here to introduce to you a very special girl band. And you will appreciate them because they're all homegrown. They're all from Dudley. And they're here to sing their very first single, all right? And I want you to give them a very big warm welcome because this is the first time they will be appearing on national television. So meet and greet the fabulous 21st Century Girls.
Is bright. Don't give me your time.
what energy. It does not make me feel old. It really does. And all your mums, wrote, because there's two girls who are sisters. That's you, yes, Leanne, and Fiona. Come on, girls. Come on, the mums. These are the mums, everybody. Come on, girls. Oh, yes, we've got Rakshinda, we've got Maria, and we've got Anne. And what are all your family and relatives going to say? When you get home, weren't you proud of them today?
I'm really proud of them.
I bet you can't wait to get home and phone all your relatives.
Yeah,
is that right, Maria?
That's right.
And I know you've got a lot of relatives, haven't you? They're scattered all over the place now. Rakshinda, your mum and dad still live in Pakistan. Is that right?
That's right, yeah.
And what about you, Maria? You've got relatives. You've got mum and dad in Australia. Mm. And Anne, you've got a lovely sister in Cyprus. Is that right?
Yes.
What do you think your sister in Cyprus will say after today?
Oh, she'll love it.
She'll absolutely love it. Well, I know your sister will love it, and I certainly know your mum and dad will love it, and I certainly know your mum and dad will love it, because surprise, surprise, they're here, they're right here in Britain. Come on, gang, come on, the relatives, where are you? Yes, all your grandmothers and your granddads are here. Take a break there, but please don't go away. Please join us again in a couple of minutes. I'll see you then.
Thank you very much from Yorkshire Puddings. A la gravy, Brussels sprouts and roast potatoes. Thank you very, very, very much.
Road tax dodgers can now be clamped or towed away. And if they still refuse to pay up, politely but firmly, pressed for payment. Road tax. There's no getting away with it.
The new improved Super Seacat Fast Ferry will take you and your car direct to Dublin from Liverpool in under 4 hours. Ask your travel agent about the daily Super Seacat sailings. You could win £20,000 or hundreds of other big money prizes now in Gala's Carnival of Cash Free Draw. Gala, the bingo that gets you buzzing.
Thank you very much for being my mum. Thank you very much. Thank you very, very much. Thank you very, 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 very much. Oh, Cheryl.
Let's face it, straight is boring. That's why I love Le Grand Curl. L'Oreal's first mascara ever to curl your lashes all by itself. Really, it's new. Amazing technology that actually curls for a longer look.
It's an eye-opener.
So for me, it's bye-bye eyelash curler. And hello, new L'Oreal Le Grand Curl.
Because you're worth it.
What would you do if Britain's favourite brand of bread tasted even better?
Smile, though your heart is aching. Smile, even though it's breaking.
New Kingsmill Top Grade, even more of a fresh baked taste to make you smile.
What does it mean to be a man? To be a gentleman. Really gentle and really a man.
Contradiction for Men, new from Calvin Klein.
One, two, and again, big voice, really big voice.
You're doing well, you're doing well.
Come and join me, Jean, on the Cilla sofa. Wow. Down there,
down on the sofa, Jean, because all your friends at the hospital ordered me to. Because, you see, they've got a special message for you, Jean. Have a look at the screen over there.
Jean, thanks for all the work you do. You're really appreciated. Cheers.
I do appreciate you, Jean, because, I mean, you're a little, I mean, you're always on the go, aren't you?
Yes.
And you are a
bed manager.
Bed manager. I've never heard of that before. Besides being a bed manager, you do lots of things. You're a treasurer and events organiser, is that right?
Yeah, that's
and you
nice
do stuff. All this for all the nurses, all the staff at the hospital. Well, what sort of things do you organise for everybody?
On Monday, we're off to Euro Disney with all the children.
Are you really?
Yeah, in May we go to Blackpool.
Oh, wonderful.
We have dances, karaoke nights.
You do all that? Well, I had a little word with the girls and they said it's about time you had a rest and it's about time you stopped. And that's what you're here for. They also told me that you are mad about cruises, although you've never ever been on a cruise. Is it your dream to go on
yes.
one? Well, Jean, surprise, surprise, you are going on a cruise. Yes.
Lovely.
And what's more, here to tell you all about it, oh, is a lovely actor. I miss him so much from Coronation Street. Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome Roy Barraclough. Come in, Roy.
Congratulations.
Thank you.
Oh, that's lovely.
What's she going to be doing on this cruise?
Well, I've got two tickets here for a fabulous sunshine cruise on the Oriana.
The Oriana?
Yeah, now it's calling at some really exciting ports in France, Portugal and Spain. And it's the genuine thing, Jean. It's not one of Alec Gilroy's no. dodgy deals.
Do you want to have a look at the ship you're going on?
Yeah.
There's the Oriana. Look at that. Those. Can't be bad. Enjoy it. Two tickets so you can take anyone you like. And you can't take our Roy here. But Roy, what you can do for us is mm-hmm. take our Jean off and give her a taste of what's to come. A glass of champagne.
Hey. What's all this? I thought this was a family show.
It is. It's them. They're making up their own jokes out there. Naughty, naughty. We're talking about champagne here. Have you got the bottle open?
I've got it all ready.
Oh, well, get that.
I'd be delighted. Jean, come
ladies
on.
Ladies and gentlemen, all thanks to Roy and you lovely Jean. Well, now, thank you, oh, God bless. Well, now, I'm looking for somebody in our audience who's a very big EastEnders fan. And I do believe it's you, Hilary Agostini. It is you. You love EastEnders, don't you?
I love EastEnders. I
know
watch it
this.
Every week.
I knew this already because Mario, your lovely husband here, told me all about it. Is she really mad? Is she that keen on EastEnders?
Fanatical.
Who's her favourite? Who she watches in?
Martin McCutcheon.
Oh, that's Tiffany. Surprise, surprise. She's here tonight just to say hello to you. Yes, come in, Martine McCutcheon. Come on, Martine. Very big fan. And I believe you did cry your eyes out when... we all did when you went.
I did.
And I bet you are. So pleased that you recovered tonight.
I know, I'm looking a little bit better now than when you last saw me.
You are looking stunning, isn't she, ladies and gentlemen?
I've got a little signed copy of my first single, which is yet to be released. This is the first person I've given a single to.
Oh,
so I hope you like it, and I hope you play it, and I hope you're pleased that I'm still around doing something else.
Oh, you are, and we all know it's going to go to number one. Don't we, ladies and gentlemen?
Thank you.
And surprising our Hilary here. Would you like to go and get yourself ready to sing this fabulous song? Because you are going to sing it for our Hilary and everybody else.
I'm going to sing Perfect Moment for you.
Thanks
so hope you like it, darling. Oh,
thanks
see you
a
later.
Lot, Mark. Ladies and and gentlemen, here she is singing her new single, Perfect Moment. Will you please welcome Martine McCutcheon? You must remember the lovely May earlier. Do you remember May? And a lovely daughter. Well, you've not met June. June.
Hello.
You're the one that wrote me a most very moving letter about your mum May here, didn't you?
Yes.
Ladies and gentlemen, our May is 83 years young. And you were married to your dear husband until you lost him a few years ago.
Yes.
That was your 10.
6 years ago.
You also had 5 children, of which June is one
yes.
of them.
I lost one.
Ah. Well, I know that you're Shirley. She's the eldest, isn't she?
Yes.
Now, where is Shirley now, Chuck?
In America.
But way back in 1952, she left home, didn't she?
Yes.
And she had a little baby girl.
Yes.
But unfortunately, the relationship that she was in at the time
They broke up.
Yes.
And through no fault of her own, nobody to blame, she had to put your little granddaughter, Lynn
up for adoption. Yes.
Now, June tells me that you desperately wanted to adopt Lynn yourself.
Yes.
But it was impossible at the time.
Mm-hmm.
Is that right?
Yes.
So Lynn was adopted, and the adoptive parents changed the name. Well, they lengthened her name to Linda, didn't they?
Yes.
Now, you haven't seen her, have you?
No.
Well, I do know that Linda, and as you know yourself, she did go to Australia.
Yes.
Where she married, and she had a little girl herself.
Yes.
And she called your great-granddaughter Eve Lynn, is that right?
Yes.
Wonderful. Now, can you remember back to 1991? Because it must have been a marvellous time for you when you got a letter.
Letters, yes.
Saying that your granddaughter was in Australia,
yes.
Still living in Australia. Mm-hmm. And you still have not seen her,
no,
May.
No.
Well, surprise, surprise, May. We think you're a wonderful mum. We have flown her all the way over Australia to be with you tonight. Not only that, she's brought the great-granddaughter you've never, ever met.
Oh, that's
and
beautiful.
And here she is. Come in, Linda and Evelyn.
She's like my daughter.
Oh, is she?
This one.
She's gorgeous.
Linda.
Oh, Linda's like you. Like come, Linda, sit next to her. You're very welcome. Very welcome. Sit down. Now, you know, normally at this point, I'd be over there singing me last song. But, you know, Linda, I want to talk to you about your mum, Shirley. Your mum, Shirley, over 40 years ago.
Yes.
And it's round about at the same time because you are a marvellous detective. Because you tracked your mum down to America,
yes, I did,
didn't
yes.
you? Because she married an American serviceman,
yes.
and she still lives there today.
Yes, she does, yeah.
Well, to make up the family picture, surprise, surprise.
Are you joking?
Yes, we have.
You're
Here's
joking?
Your mother, Shirley, who you've never, ever met. Come in. Shirley, say hello to your family. That's all we have time for on our special edition of Surprise, Surprise. I'd like to thank everyone who's taken part in tonight's show, especially Neil Diamond, Five, Martine McCutcheon and Roy Barraclough. Happy Mother's Day, everyone. Ta-ra, then. Ta-ra.